about 1989, we had cataloged 57 different species.
Hello, people from planet Earth and beyond. I'm Antonio. Welcome to my channel. I'll try something different. I will be sculpting alien while reading people accounts about contact with them. And hopefully this creates interesting effects and video you will enjoy. Let me know what you think in comments down below so that I know if it works. In this first episode we are going to cover grey aliens. It is designed based on many people accounts and of course my own artistic approach. Some say they come from Zeta Reticular star system. Some say that greys are drone bodies controlled by other species called mantis, which look like insects. Considering that we as humans would make human-like avatars for ourselves, it's not stretched to think that other species would do the same. Maybe a hybrid so that it can handle the atmosphere on the planet that it is visiting? Many witnesses claim that greys' eyes feel cold, almost not alive when they stare at you. Eyes are important in communication for not only humans but also animals. So I'm pretty sure that when experiencing contact with alien species you would read their eyes instinctively. My best guess is that they are indeed biological drones. What is their goal? And what is the nature of their contact with humans? It is a complete mystery for everyone and I can only speculate. But I'm completely sure that the phenomena is very real. Contact with them is very bizarre and from our perspective they don't make any sense. It seems like they are interested in our biology but even more our psychology. I read a lot of accounts throughout the years and it seems to me that they are testing different situations with humans. By abducting humans or their astral bodies and then conducting tests in different situations. Posted by a deleted account on abduction subreddit. My first abduction happened when I was 2 or 3, which could have been any time between 1981 and 1983 in Dinuba, California. I was in my room and I woke up to two thin creatures with large heads and eyes around the lamp in my room. The lamp was located across from my bed. The creatures looked like stereotypical grey alien, but with a human skin tone. I turned over in bed, worried about my stuffed animals, especially a bunny I loved, that they were on the shelf by my bed. That is when my memory of the incident ends. The odd thing is that I never saw that bunny stuffed animal again. My next abduction memory was about a year or two later, when I was probably around 4. Late 84, mid 85, in 29 Palms, California. My parents had taken me to one of their friends' houses for a party. I was put to the bed around 7:30 p.m. in a bedroom at the house. I couldn't sleep, and a while after I was put to the bed, I noticed the alarm clock on the dresser was blinking 12:00. I heard people outside talking about something in the sky, and over the next couple minutes their voices got louder and I heard them talking about UFO. I also heard a couple of military personnel at the party talking about whatever it was, an A-10 or F-14. There was a flash of light and then there were screams, and then it was quiet. I got scared and left the room. A small grey was in the hallway and told me that it was alright and they weren't there for me. He said he would take me back to the room and I followed. I don't remember seeing his lips move, and when I turned to follow the memory goes black. Can't remember what happened next other than being home and waking up in my bed. After that, it was a few years before I had a conscious encounter with the greys. When I was 11, 1991, winter spring, it was slightly chilly, at my mom's house in Cambria, California. A wooded area along the coast, kind of tourist town near Morro Bay in central California. I woke up to my bedroom door open and the front door open. It was a single-story house and very small. The front door and the room I slept in were at the opposite ends of the same hallway. There was a light shining on the deck porch, and I felt myself getting sleepy as I looked out the front door from my bedroom. Half my body felt numb and I moved forward. I felt something on my right side, punched out with my right arm, not looking or thinking really. I hit something and the next thing I know I'm looking down at the grey alien on the carpet to my right and in front of me. I feel pressure on the back of my head and everything goes black. I think I also felt like I was falling forward. I have a spotted recollections of encounters at my home in Ridley, California. A very series of memories of a girl who called herself Mirina or Marina. Dark hair and pale skin. I don't know how I would get there or get back, but we'll be sitting in a circular room with glass window walls. There were grass underneath us and a large tree in the center. She would ask me questions or play a game with red or orange cards. I never really understood the rules or even if there were any. She'd deal me some cards and we'd take turns placing them in 3x3 pattern. She looked human but was very, very pale. Sometimes I would see Grace watching outside of the glass window, but she would always get my attention away from them and distract me. After learning a little bit about Grace, I have a feeling she may have been a hybrid. If so, she looked and acted surprisingly human. At the house in Cambria years before, I would wake up with my pajamas on, backwards and upside down in bed. My feet were on my pillow and my head was under the blankets and at the foot of the bed. This is why I don't have conscious memories of the Greys, or little grey jerk as I called them, for years until I was 11. Also in Cambria when I was 16, around 1996, most likely during the summer, I woke up to see a grey looking at me through the doorway to my room. I couldn't move. Not from some sort of paralysis, but I was just scared. This is when I started to have visceral reaction when seeing them, a flight or flight response I didn't have before. Had multiple encounters while living alone when I was 23. This is early to mid 2003. I saw a grey alien in my house that would disappear moments after I saw them. They would step to the side and just disappear. I had a conscious memory of waking up to talk to a blue alien. Built similar to the Greys, head slightly smaller and I feel more human than the Greys. I call him the case manager. He would ask me two distinct questions and repeat a phrase. Red means go, green means stop. I also would oddly get an intrusive image in my mind of a tin can the day before he would appear. The last encounter I had, I woke up in what looked like an examination room in hospital. There was a small room within the room, walled off with a door on one side and a glass window looking out toward where I was. The odd thing was that next to me was a digital signed monitor and IV drip was in my arm. Behind the glass I could see the blue alien and what looked like a mantis but huge, taller than the blue alien. The blue alien was nodding and then he turned to look at me. I got drowsy and fell asleep a few seconds later. In 2017, some odd things happened. My son and daughter talked about grey aliens without prompting. I kept that past from my kids as best I could. Since they denied seeing them and my son actively disbelieves everything in regards to aliens. My wife and I would see shadows moving in the house. Both of us would see them, not just one of us. We'd also see small white orbs quickly flying around the house. My wife would also wake up with bruises, which may or may not be explainable. This happened over the course of about 6 months, with one or two incidents a week. So over the course of 4 decades, I've seen 5 distinct types of entities. Flesh color grays, grays, a possible hybrid, a blue and a mantis. I wouldn't have thought they were connected to aliens for one important reason. I never saw a ship. The only link to UFOs is when during my second encounter, the adults outside used the term UFO. And when I first saw the stereotypical grey on the cover of Communion and also the movie which I saw in 2000s. Not exactly what I saw but close enough for government work. Posted by Sovinios on abduction subreddit. My abductors helped me with my anxiety and saved my parents' lives so I can do missions for them. I've been questioning as to where I've been abducted for the past few days. Especially after making a post about whether I'm being abducted or not. But then, just as I was coming to terms that I was abducted, I wouldn't remember anything. Aliens I met before came back. At this point, I feel obligated to share my story, so here it is. P.S. This is a bit a long story since it chronicles my entire abduction experiences up to this point. This is even getting into the absurd, possibly alien, experiences that my family has witnessed. Regardless, this post will take a while, so be prepared to read. P.S. I don't remember the exact dialogue. I simply restated the dialogue in the best I could remember. To start, my first abduction happened when I was 10, back in July of 2013. I snuck outside to my backyard to look at the stars, which I often did when I was young, since space has always fascinated me, even today. That was when I saw it. Through a couple of clouds in the sky that day, I saw the bottom of the saucer, with its light shining on me. Initially, I didn't remember anything after that. I woke up several hours later, in my bed, just confused. But as discussed later on the story, I was given my memories back. I can describe what this abduction entailed. The next thing I knew, I was within a rather large room, which I could assume is within the saucer itself. Pretty much a simple circular white room with nothing in it, and a single curve connecting the floor and ceiling. Although there was no visible light source, it seems as though there was light coming from the center of the floor and the ceiling. There, I was on a steel table, face up and paralyzed. Four short greys surrounded me and were using strange metal tools. Mostly tools that looked like small steel rods, but they had a lot of them in their hands. If you're curious about how the greys looked like, they look very, very similar to the cover of the book Communion. Though perhaps their eyes were rounded a tiny bit more, and their noses were a tiny bit smaller. They all had solid royal blue jumpsuits on. They moved their tools around my chest and stuck tools up my nostrils and ears. They also pointed green lasers at my eyes and stuck needles into my forehead. It hurt a lot. I was hyperventilating in pain and confusion and fear. It felt traumatic at first. But then, all of that pain stopped when I heard it. "Calm down, my sweet little child," rang in my mind. It was a telepathic message. Through the wall, a tall gray face drew on a floating white chair. She wore a long, long dress with the same shade of royal blue as the shorter grays. She was looking right at me. I knew the voice came from her, somehow. Upon her saying that, all fear and pain washed away from my body. Even though there was tools and needles within my head at that point, I felt calm, happy, comfortable even. Stayed like that for what felt like a couple more minutes. With me happy, the woman staring at me and the four greys touching my head with tools. Eventually though, the four greys stopped working on me. I, still paralyzed, suddenly started being lifted in the air. The bottom of the room lit up in the blinding light. And before I knew it, I was back in my backyard. Except this time, I was levitating in the air while the four greys from before were nearby me. It was still nighttime when the greys walked towards my house. They opened my back door without even touching it and levitated both me and themselves through the house. Soon enough, they placed me in the bed, causing me to fall asleep. I woke up at 5 a.m, sleeping on my back in my bed while my sheets were straightened. Which isn't normal at all. I normally sleep on my side and my sheets aren't strengthened when I wake up. Between my first and second abduction, I had nightmares, repeated nightmares. Looking back, many of these nightmares depicted a distorted form of my first abduction. However, my memories were initially wiped off my first abduction, so I wasn't able to figure out the source of these strange nightmares. Oftentimes, my nightmares featured me being in a dark room, pursued by shadow figures and being entirely helpless. Everything changed though when I learned how to lucid dream at age 13. Being sick of nightmares, I searched for ways online to try to get rid of nightmares. And one of those things was lucid dreaming. For whatever reason, I picked up lucid dreaming absurdly quick. I had a sleep paralysis, but only twice before I learned how to lucid dream nearly consistently. Within a month, I went from having constant uncontrollable nightmares to having pleasant lucid dreams almost every night. It was nice. Lucid dreams allow me to look deep within myself. Not only would I have fun during my dreams, but I could ask my subconsciousness things about myself that I wouldn't have known otherwise. For unknown reasons, I also began to have dreams that predicted the future. Most often they would depict a storm like a tornado or thunderstorms about 3 days before these storms appeared. I also had dreams predicting the bodies, but not faces, of people I would meet in the future and my relationships with them, most often friends. And even dreams predicting rooms that I'd be in, despite me having never been in said rooms. These clairvoyant dreams happened once every couple of weeks uncontrollably, and would feel stronger than a normal dream or even lucid dream. Regardless, as time went on, I improved my lucid dreaming skills more and more. Over the next few years, as I grew to ages 14, 15, 16, my control over my dreams became stronger and more effortless. Then came my second abduction. I went to sleep on the night of April or May in 2019. I was 16 then. At the time, I had paper stuck in my right ear. A bit of a weird story, but I have a hearing sensitivity due to my autism. Before I choose to get noise-canceling headphones, I would block out noise by covering my ears with crumpled paper. One of those crumpled bits got stuck in my right ear though, so oops. Anyways, unlike last time where I was conscious on my trip from the craft, I simply appeared standing in a small corridor of sorts. At first, I tried to check if I was dreaming, which I do by attempting to manipulate the wall, checking my hands to see if they look normal, etc. But to my surprise, it seemed as though I wasn't dreaming. To my left of that corridor was a wall of several switches, lights and latches. Looks sort of similar to the front of the really old computer of sorts. Naturally, I didn't bother touching any of them. To the right were two short greys, standing there in the same blue jumpsuits that I saw them before. I felt terrified at first, of course, especially since I forgot about my first abduction at this point. But then I saw the tall alien I met before, telepathically saying the same thing she said before. Calm down, my sweet little child. My fear washed away as the two aliens and I walked towards her. The room we were in looked exactly like my abduction room, except it had four beige doors. These doors are capable of sliding upward for someone to go through them. The two aliens took similar metal tools to the ones they used last time. Although they didn't stick any needles into my head or anything. They just quickly moved the tools around my body. The grey on the right didn't notice something in my right ear though, and reached in using these metal clamps to pull it out. My first thought was, who are you and what I'm doing here? Which she responded with, I'm your watcher. I will answer your other questions later. Now, follow me, she telepathically said. And I followed her through the beige door that opened by sliding upwards. We went through another small corridor before reaching a room slightly smaller than the room I was just in. Just like the previous room though, had nothing in it other than the two corridors that led to the beige door separately, one of which we just came from, as well as a giant window. The window showed outer space. It looked beautiful, but it was more or less space. My watcher told me to look at her, which I followed obediently. Staring into her big, deep eyes, I could tell that her eyes weren't just pure black, but were rather a very, very dark blue. Her skin was also relatively a bit more green compared to the other, shorter greys I saw earlier. After staring into her eyes for a bit, she then said that, now you can see. I looked back through the window and my goodness, it was space. But far, far more magical. It looked like your typical artist paintings you'd see when searching for HD wallpapers of space, but somehow even better than that. It's like I could see the red-like hues, green-yellow-like hues, and purple-like hues that were hues that you normally couldn't see in real life. My watcher told me that this is what I could see if I could master my mind. I then woke up laying on my back with straightened sheets once again. At a time, I woke up with no memory of what actually occurred, although I did notice later that that day the paper stuck in my ear was completely gone. In addition, in the following years, I would have lucid dreams where I could see colors I couldn't see in real life. I was never sure where these dreams came from or why they happened, at least not until recently. 3 years later, 19 years old, it was about 1 a.m. on October 30th. 2021, when the third abduction occurred. At this point in time, I was beginning to research about the UFO and UAP phenomena. out of curiosity for the past month. Over time, however, I began to piece together that maybe, just maybe, a lot of weird things that occurred in my life, from my nightmares to my family experiences, being able to see strange shadow entities, among other issues, was entirely because of me being abducted. As I was walking downstairs to get a midnight snack, I saw the tall alien, my watcher, standing right by my front door. Judging by the height of the door that I measured after the abduction, I could tell that she is about 7 foot 2 inches to 7 foot 3 inches tall. Despite seeing an unwanted being in my house, seeing her made me feel calm somehow. As I heard the same phrase I heard before in my head, "Calm down, my sweet little child." Wanting to get evidence, I lifted my phone, which was in my hand at the time, and rushed to turn it on. But the instant I even thought to capture her on camera, she vanished. "Come downstairs," I heard in my mind. I came downstairs, albeit cautiously, had my phone on to capture them on camera, and was ready to yell to wake my parents if anything bad happened. The second I walked into my kitchen, though, I saw the four short greys I saw earlier, and my vision blanked out. The next thing I knew, I was in a saucer I saw earlier, although without my phone and sitting on one of those floating alien chairs. The four short greys surrounded my chair, and directly in front of me was a tall grey, sitting on her own chair in front of me. Despite everything, I still felt unusually calm. It was almost like I was at home, really. My first thought was to check if this was a dream by checking if my hands looked normal and trying to manipulate the world around me. I'm a pretty good lucid dreamer at this point, so I figured out how to discern dreams from reality. Both checks, however, seemed to suggest that this way in some way reality. My watcher said, "Look at me," and I looked. As she stared into my eyes and I into hers, my forgotten memories of my past abductions came flooding back. "I'm your watcher," her voice echoed in my mind, "but you can call me Mama." After that, I felt dizzy for a bit. She continued to stare at me while I had to close my eyes. Over the next couple of seconds, a dozen thoughts a second rushed into my mind. "I answered all of your questions," she said telepathically in her soothing voice. "I'll list these questions and answers towards the end of the pose to let the story continue." She then told me, "Though to a separate telepathic message, that we are contacting you because your family has a great psionic potential. However, your anxiety is getting in the way." She lifted me up in the air without lifting a finger and moved me across the room into her lap, cradling me like a baby. "Look at me again." Looking into her deep, dark blue eyes, I heard her in my mind saying, "Calm down, my sweet little child." Or should I say, "Calm down, my sweet little girl." I must have had a positive reaction to the latter, because she started repeating, "Calm down, my sweet little girl," in my head, over and over and over again. It felt soothing and euphoric, like I never felt this comfortable in my entire life. Eventually, after what seemed like hours, she said, "If you ever get scared or feel pain, just think of me, your mama, okay?" The last words I heard before I fell asleep in her arms was, "I need to learn astral projection next. We'll come back once you master that." Suddenly I woke up on the couch in my family room at 2:30 a.m., which was weird since I didn't even enter my family room from my memory. This was especially weird since I usually sleep from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. or so. I'm never even remotely tired at this time. At first, I tried my best to dismiss what happened as a dream. It couldn't have happened, right? But whenever I think of my watcher or mama, I get a soothing sensation unlike any other. My anxiety, despite me having a severe case anxiety disorder, has always disappeared whenever I thought of her. In addition, I suffered from daily headaches and body pains, which was diagnosed as fibromyalgia by a rheumatologist in February. Even though the headaches and pains have gotten better as I followed my doctor's treatments, these headaches and pains have never fully went away until this abduction incident. I have yet to have a headache or pain in my body since, and it's been nearly a week when I usually feel these pains daily. Questions I asked my watcher that she answered. During my third abduction incident, I mentioned how the tall gray I met, my watcher, my mama, telepathically answered all the questions I had. Here's her answers. Question: why did you abduct me? Answer: we abduct your family line because you and your family have high psionic abilities. However, your relatives, she showed an image of my dad and grandma in my mind, have ignored the truth for religion. You are more open-minded. Question: how long have you been following my family line? Answer: 237 years. Question: why did my parents' car teleport? For context, my parents and I experienced our car teleporting to a completely different part of the town while my dad was driving in May of 2015. Answer: to save your parents' lives. If you didn't save your parents, this would interfere with your psychic abilities. Question: why did you wait until now? Answer: we knew you would come to the conclusion that you've been abducted. We waited until then, as well as once you mastered your lucid dreaming. Question: what is behind the four beige doors? Answer: the deck, the window, the pilot room, and the engine room. Question: are there other rooms? Answer: yes. Question: can I see them? Answer: no. Question: what are the aliens? You, Grace? Answer: for as long as you live, we cannot tell you or humanity. This was also the answer to many other questions regarding the nature of the universe, their technology, where they live, etc. Question: what technology do you use? Answer: EM, electromagnetism, I presume, and psionics. You wouldn't understand if I told you. Question: is religion real? Answer: yes, all are to some degree. Question: if you are a watcher, what other aliens exist? Answer: there are watchers / observers, those who reproduce, and others. I personally call those who reproduce breeders. Question: would a reproducing alien abduct me? Answer: no, that would interfere with your purpose. We specifically have you and your family marked to not reproduce with. Question: what is my purpose? Answer: to learn psychic abilities. You should also have children, preferably 3 to 4, if possible, given how well we predict you can handle children. But we won't force you to, since we know you don't want children. If you follow what we say, then this will be the best for both of us. She then telepathically showed me clairvoyant visions, including a vision of what life career I should pursue, what a future romantic partner of mine would look like, and a vision of me floating in space, seeing colors that I normally can't see in real life. As you can hear from both accounts, contacts are usually very confusing. It's very difficult to point out the meaning of the abductions because we have limited information about pretty much anything. My guess is that we are interesting both physically and mentally. Our creativity is what is being tested over and over again. Are we co-creators of reality by just thinking and we don't even realize it? Doesn't that sound like a dream state? If so, is this reality just another dream with specific time perception? I think so. That's why the alien story is so bizarre to us. To understand any form of alien life, we'll have to understand ourselves better first. To even be able to understand what kind of perception is necessary to have a conversation with them. I think we have it in ourselves, but we are being held hostage by our system. What I mean by that, well, our creativity is often killed in traditional schooling system, because the teacher tells you that there is only one correct answer. Plus the bad grades and shaming and puff. Just through those simple mechanisms, you teach kids to hate learning and to be scared of authority. Okay, but how is that connected with talking to aliens, right? Well, creativity is a visual mental language. To be able to understand complex ideas, you can't be locked out by thoughts like, this is silly, this is childish, this is not possible. An example could be when people are trying new languages. Fear and shame blocks you, and you end up not practicing the language, even though you can speak a little bit maybe. And that same fear can come from years of schooling, you know, getting bad scores when you're not correct as a teacher wants you to be. All of this is like a literal handbrake for developing multidimensional conversation and understanding. And add 70 years of lying and propaganda, and we are completely lost about who are we, who they are, and what they want. We are clueless. We are like naked, scared children on a cosmic level. But it's never too late to start practicing your intuition and imagining whatever you want to imagine. Free yourselves from the norms this sick society created. Take responsibility in your own hands and trust yourself more. Thank you.